Alright, what's up guys and gals? Today we're going to go over something that every fisherman should have, especially a cat fisherman, and that is a toolbox. So I'm going to go through with you my toolbox and what I carry with me every single time I go out. Some of it, you know, some of it I don't always use, I should say. You know, it's there just in case I need it. You know, better to be prepared, right? So, like I said, I'm going to show you my tackle box, what I carry, and let's take a look. Okay, guys, here is the tackle box. It is made by a brand called Wild River. This tackle box cost me, I think, around $150, but I bought it 2 years ago, and as you can see, it's in pretty good shape. The first thing you'll probably notice are these speakers. So what makes this tackle box pretty cool that you've got a cable here and a place for your phone. You just hook, you know, put your phone in there, hook this up to your phone, and you can either use batteries. It's got a battery pack inside, or you can use a plug-in. You know, if you're at home or in the garage or something, you can plug it right in, and you've got a pretty decent sound system. You know, it's not the greatest, but it is definitely, you know, all that you need on a boat. Especially for me, you know, I've got a John boat, so I don't really have a nice stereo system hooked up in my boat. So that's one of the reasons why I bought it. It's for the sound system. So, you know, very cool. You can listen to some tunes while you're out fishing. Another thing that I really love is down here at the bottom. Got a rain fly. So whenever it starts raining, there you go. Your toolbox or your tackle box is not getting wet. I've used this a few times. It works great. Everything stayed dry. Okay guys, we got that put away. Now let's take a look. So the tackle box comes with a carry strap, two handles, and it's got a pretty nice overfolding lap there that keeps water and other things from getting in. So as you can see, I keep quite a bit of stuff in the main pocket. Keep a couple lures for fishing for flatheads. Of course, got the pair of Costas, right? 580 glass lenses. Awesome for fishing. And then I keep a couple different things align in there. I keep some Trilene Big Game. This is 40 pound test. So is this. I keep this for my leader line. I just keep a couple rolls of that in there. And then I've got some 6 pound test that I use for tying off some sinkers on some like three-way rigs. And this is some more 40 pound test for more leader line. So now as you can see in here, here's the battery compartment. I actually use it for medicine, like Tylenol, some chapstick. I keep a small hook container in there. And this is more for, you know, if I need to catch some bait fish, or, you know, want to try for some bass or something real quick. You know, I just keep a selection of different size hooks in there. This is more for non-catfishing fish. Like I said, I might try to catch some panfish, but I've got another setup for that, actually. One of my other containers, I just call it small tackle. I've got everything in here from, you know, the beads, swivels, the stops, got three-way swivels, you know, some split shot if I need that, some sinker slides for braided and mono, just some different types of swivels, of course some stops. So yeah, like I said, I just keep a little bit of everything in there. And of course got the lid box. Here I keep all my no-roll sinkers and some bells. Got some more lures there for the flatheads. And here's my catfishing hooks. And I've got everything in here. So I've got everything to catch small cats to extremely large cats, you know. I got some monster size hooks in there. This is probably my go-to though. I think this is a 5-aught. It's probably the one I use the most. Got some big old trebles in there. And then, you know, some small trebles. You know, I'd even use that with some stink bait. So, like I said, I keep a little bit of everything in the hook bin. I'm just kind of depending on what kind of catfish I'm going to go after. Small ones, big ones, whatever. And then I've got a miscellaneous bin. This is mostly Whisker Seeker tackle stuff. Got some of their floats, their rattlers. And these are, you know, very good for trolling for catfish. So that's why I carry this. I'm not always on lakes. I'm usually fishing the river, but if I do get on the lake, this stuff works great. Some of these have the stinger hook on them. They've got two. You got the Big Berthas, you know, some normal size ones, metal propellers. So this is mostly stuff I use for trolling or drifting. Okay, so that was the main pocket. Let's go ahead and turn this around. And now there's one big pocket on the back. It does have a mesh pocket here. I just keep a pair of gloves in there for, you know, whatever reason. So in this pocket, this is basically my tool bag. Of course, keep the fish grips there. I can't live without those. And then I've got my bait knife here. Then I've got a knife sharpener. So those are my three tools that are always at the go. Now in the back here, I keep a couple different things. Gurkha, one of my sponsors from Gurkha Cigars, sent me this really nice blade. Pretty nice, huh? So, keep that on the boat. Never know when you might need that. Electrical tape. If you're a rugby player, this is good for taping up broken noses. And I got another knife and hook sharpener. I also keep a fillet knife on there just in case I decide to do any filleting on the boat, or if I want to, you know, maybe fillet up some fish for bait, you know, throughout the fillet side instead of the head or whatever. I keep a Leatherman, basically, multi-purpose tool on the boat, you know, just in case I, whatever, need an extra pair of pliers, little knife. I do keep a tool bag stocked with good tools on the boat, but just in case I'm not on the boat, go fishing in someone else's boat or on the shore, you know, it's good to have this stuff with you. Got a pair of long pliers. Get down inside the fish. Get some of those stubborn hooks. And also got a pair of whisker seekers locking fish grips. And that's it for my tool pouch. Okay. Turn on this side. You'll notice it's got a pocket on either side, actually. On this side, I keep my scissors. And I keep some carbiners on here for hooking my rag to my belt loop or whatever reason. These come in handy. So I always just keep a few with me. In this little pocket here, I just keep a simple scale. Bass Pro Shops, nothing fancy. In this pocket, keep a couple headlamps. You know, you start fishing at night, need to see what you're doing. So keep those there. And it's also got a zippered pocket. And in here I keep some steel leaders, again, in case I, you know, want to fish for some walleye or something. Keep a bobber bag. You got some catfish bobbers. And then some stringers. So in this pocket, I basically keep just a little bit of odds and ends. On the other side here, again, you can see it's got the pocket for the pliers. Down in here, I keep a reel cleaning kit in case I ever have to do any maintenance on my reels. A little screwdriver, a brush, some oil, some grease in there, some Q-tips. So that's always good to have. You never know, you know, if you only took a couple reels with you, you might have to fix one real quick. In the zippered pocket here, this is where I keep my bait catching stuff. So I use all this for catching bluegills, sunfish. I bring another pole that's rigged up for that. You know, power baits, stuff like that. This is a nice pocket because it's got a clear plastic zippered pocket on the inside where the other one does not. It just has a, you know, normal pocket. So, well, guys, there you go. That's my toolbox and what I keep in it. Again, I don't always use all those things every time I go out, but they are there just in case I need them. Like I said, it's better to be prepared. So good luck, guys. Get out there, go fishing, and tight lines.